Hey guys, welcome to lesson number 10. We are graphing piecewise functions for real this time, so that's why it's part two. I'm gonna keep this video as short and sweet as I can. There's two sections to this delta math assignment. One is finding the domain graphically. This is another one of those back to the basics. Let's just get our domain down, which is gonna be super helpful for any tests that you take. If you take AP Calculus, getting that notation down is just something that you will never have to worry about if you take care of it now. And the second thing we're going to do is I'm going to have somebody who can do it better, a little better than me, teach you how to graph piecewise functions in two different ways. There's two different strategies that you can use. And then I will come back in and show you exactly how to input your graphs onto Delta Math. And that's about it. I'm going to keep it as short and sweet as possible because I know that your time is very valuable.
All right, this is your quick demonstration of how to graph a piecewise function. We're going to use an example function. F of x is going to equal x plus 5 for x less than or equal to negative 3. It's going to equal x squared plus 1 for x greater than negative 3 and less than or equal to 2. It's going to equal 1 half x minus 5 for x greater than 2. Unsurprisingly, a piecewise function is called that because it's defined in pieces. So f of x doesn't just equal one thing, it equals a different thing depending on where you are in the x value. So this function is going to have three pieces. From negative 3 and over to the left, because it's less than, in between negative 3 and 2, and then finally from 2 off to the right because it's greater than. Let's go ahead and see how this is. All right, before we start graphing the actual piecewise function, here it is again, we're going to consider the pieces separately. So if you consider the first part, the line x plus 5, that by itself would just be y equals x plus 5. So here we have a y-intercept of 5, a slope of 1, our line looks like that. If we consider the middle piece, we know that that's a parabola. And it's a regular parabola, except it's shifted up 1. So its vertex is at 0, 1. We draw the beautiful shape. If we don't really know that, we can always plot points. So that's what that part looks like. And then finally, our last piece is another line. It's got a slope, it's got a y-intercept of negative 5 and a slope of 1 half. So there it is. So these are our three separate pieces graphed in yellow, blue, and purple. If I asked you to graph them separately, obviously that's what they'd look like. But that's not what I'm asking you. I'm asking you to graph the piecewise function that is all of them with the domain restrictions that you're given, the less than negative 3, in between, and so on. And there are two ways to do this. So the first way to graph a piecewise function is to graph all three functions on the same set of axes and then erase as you need to. So we'll look at our function again. Super tiny because we've seen it a whole bunch of times. There it is. Okay, so what I can do, so I can take all three functions and I can graph them all, and then I can get rid of the bits that I don't need. So I started by graphing all of them all at once, and you'll see that I've gotten rid of certain pieces. So the yellow graph, which used to be a big line, now it's only the part where x is negative 3 and to the left, meaning less than negative 3. You'll notice that the yellow graph ends in a dot. That's because it's less than or equal to negative 3. So that point is actually included. On the other hand, if you look at the other point, that's where x is negative 3, the part on the blue graph, you'll see it's an open circle. And it's an open circle because that's it's greater than negative 3. But on the other side, it's less than or equal to negative 2, so the other end of the blue graph is closed. And then finally, we have the line that is the last piece. As you can see, I've erased all of the line except the part to the right of 2. And again, it's an open circle because it's greater than 2, not greater than or equal to 2. So that point will not be included. So that's way one, where you just take all three, you graph them completely, and then you erase stuff that you don't want. That's more work, but it's also a little bit more straightforward. Option number two takes less time, but you have to be really comfortable with your graphing. So the second way to graph it is to use what we call the boundary points. Those are the ones that are going to be open circle or closed circle. And then to use your knowledge of the graph to see where it comes from. So first, the first boundary point will be where x is negative 3 in the yellow function. So if I plug negative 3 in for x in the yellow function, the x plus 5, I get 2. And it's less than or equal to, so I draw myself a closed dot. I know that I want less than or equal to, so I have to draw the part of that line that's to the left. And I know that the line has a slope of 1, so I draw another point to give me the slope of 1, and then I just shoot down toward the less than side. In the middle, I need 2 boundary points. I need negative 3 and I need 2, so I get those y values. I can plot the open circle all the way up at negative 3, 10. I can plot the closed circle on the other side at 2, 5. And then again, I use my knowledge of the fact that this is a parabola. So I know that its vertex is going to be at 0, 1. And then I just threw in the one more point that's symmetric to 2 comma 5 so I can get a good shape to my parabola. And that's all I need because it's got to be between negative 3, dot included, and 2 included. And then finally, we have the line. I plug in 2 to the line, I get negative 4, and then I use the fact that the slope is 1 half to go up 1 over 2. And I know I'm going to the right because it says x greater than 2. And that's pretty much it. Now I don't have to erase anything. I have all three pieces and I've reflected my entire graph.
Hey guys, so using the same example that you just saw, I'm going to show you exactly how you would put your information, your answer, into Delta Math. So we're using the same exact example. The one pointer I want to give you is that you will actually not get any quadratic functions for Delta Math, but this is a really good example to see that piecewise functions aren't all linear. But we really want to keep it simple. We do have this barrier of graphing on a computer. That is just really the best way to do it. So without further ado, let's start with this first piece. So you have a line, x plus 5, and it only exists for the domain that's less than negative 3. That means that my line isn't going to pass negative 3. So if it's x plus 5, then we have a line, right, with a slope of 1 that crosses, if it could, would cross the x-axis right at 5, but it doesn't. So we're going to start it right here, and we're going to draw it out with the same slope of 1 out there. So it includes negative 3, so you can leave that in as a filled-in circle, but it doesn't actually stop at negative 9. This just keeps on going. So you're going to click on that point twice. It doesn't matter where at this point, just somewhere to the left of, so that it shows that it's a line. You're going to click it twice, and that'll show that it goes all the way to negative infinity, and it ends, if you're moving to the right, at negative 3. So I'm going to skip graphing the quadratic that we have here because it's just not possible to do that on here. So let's look at the next line. So the next line starts at positive 2 when x is greater than 2. And your intercept, your y-intercept, is at negative 5. So it doesn't start at negative 5. It starts at positive 2. So you have to start it right at the correct point. So I just went up 1 over 2 because that's my slope is 1 half. I'm going to start it here and do the same thing. Up 1 over 2, up 1 over 2. As far as short as I like, I could go up here. I'm just going to stick right here. I'm going to keep it safe. So we've got it there. So on the left-hand side, you see that it doesn't include negative 2. It starts right after negative 2. So I'm going to click on it once to make it a non-inclusive value. And then on the right, you see that it keeps on going after 2. So you're going to click on that point, the end of your line, twice to make it an arrow. So this is how you would input that information onto Delta Math. If you're on your phones, just be patient with it. It will work. I promise. That's it. I hope that was really helpful, and I will see you on the next go round.